By sorption I should term you will know the water activity of particular product at what moisture content, or you will also get at what moisture content what wet water activity is there of that product. So you will know the relation between these two, water activity, yes, versus water content,
moisture content.
So you will get the relationship. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, what are the advantages? Advantages of dried food. So this dried and dehydrated foods are highly concentrated food. Why? Why it is concentrated? Highly concentrated, not concentrated. It is highly concentrated food compared to any other preserved form of foods.
Even so, water remove ho gaya.
Yes.
Water content kam rehta hai.
We have removed the water. So whatever the molecules is there inside, that is will be in the highly concentrated form. Protein, fat, vitamins, minerals, all will be in the concentrated form. Drying reduces the microbial activity and thus reduces the spoilage of food due to microbial contamination. Like in fresh fish, if we are getting the fish from the pond or from the water, we can't preserve for longer duration of time until and unless some other method of preservation we have applied. For fresh fish, always we are using ice. In ice also, we can't store for longer duration of time because we can reduce the activity of microbes and we can reduce the activity of enzymes, but we can't store. But here in dried product or dried foods, we can stop the activity of microbes. We can stop the activity of enzyme. How? We are removing the water. The water which requires, which supports the growth of microorganism. The water which enhances the chemical reaction. So that water we are removing, that is free water. That's why we are stopping the growth of microbes as well as the enzyme, activity of enzyme. With reduced water content, enzymic and many chemical processes are retarded. So that is the advantages of dried food. Dried foods are less expensive to produce. Why? Because here we don't require a expensive equipment or sophisticated instrument or more complicated machinery to produce the food or to produce the dried fish or dried foods or dried products. That's why it is less expensive. No involvement of complicated machinery and equipment for processing and packaging. Then stable at most ambient temperature. Other foods, say for example, ice, we have to always keep fish in ice condition at 0°C to 5°C or refrigerated temperature throughout the storage. But in case of dried foods, we don't require such type of control, temperature control. So it will be stable at most ambient temperature or room temperature. We don't require to reduce or increase the temperature. Then distribution cost is also minimum. So these are the some advantages of dried food. Then this another one is advantages of salt curing over other method of processing. So this salted fish or salting of fish we have studied, but what is the advantage of this salt curing over other method of processing? It does not require elaborate equipment, just like drying. It doesn't require. Captain outlay is small. Here also we require less investment. Then methods are simple and the processes are completely inexpensive. This is also inexpensive. Unlike other sophisticated method of processing, curing can be applied for preservation of any type of fish. We can apply salting. We can apply salt curing for any type of fish. Then finished products do not require any special storage facility. Then products have reasonably good shelf life. Then nutritionally, the products are comparable to fish processed employing most other methods. So these are the some advantages of salt curing or salted fish. So today, I think this is all about the drying and dehydration. Then advantages, and then this water content and water activity. If you are having any confusion, then you may ask. Then we will go in detail about this drying. This is the beginning. Before going to the process of drying, we have to know about this principle of drying. What is drying? What is the difference between drying and dehydration? Water content or water activity? Then we will go in detail how this drying process and what are the factors which affects the drying process. Then how, what are the different types of drying or types of dryer, and then influence of drying on the nutritional quality of the fish. So we will study in detail, but today class is up to this. If you're having any confusion, you may ask. It's a very interesting topic: salting, drying, smoking, fermenting, marinating. Because all these are oldest method of preservation. In earlier days, people were using salting, drying, smoking. So salting we have completed. Drying, we are in drying, and then we will go to smoking. Any confusion you may ask?
सर
प्रेम
सर जो जॉबसन आइसोथर्म में है तो उसमें अलग अलग डिफरेंट टेम्परेचर का जो कर्व आएगा सभी सिग्माइड ही होगा सर
नो इफ यू आर एक्सप्रेसिंग और इफ यू आर प्लॉटिंग दिस ऑप्शन आइसोथर्म्स सो ऑलवेज आइदर यू हैव टू प्लॉट एट पर्टिकुलर टेम्परेचर ऑफ इक्विलिब्रियम मॉइस्चर कंटेंट और वाटर एक्टिविटी और You have to calculate for a range of temperature. ऐसा नहीं है एक बार में हमने एक temperature ले लिया और बाद में हम range of temperature लेकर के plot कर रहे हैं. If you are plotting, then you go by one. एक बार में अगर plot करना है तो range of temperature लेके भी कर सकते हैं या नहीं तो हम एक particular temperature पे लेके भी कर सकते हैं. It depends on your choice.
Okay, sir.
Ultimately, you will get the moisture content and water activity.
Yes.
And if you are plotting the graph between all these two, between these two, that is your Shobson isotherm.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Anyone? No doubt. सब समझ में आ गए. बोल ही नहीं रहा यार हाँ या ना कुछ तो बोलो ओके दैट मींस आज का क्लास आई थिंक हमें लग रहा है स्टॉप करना चाहिए फिर
यस सर
ओके
थैंक यू सर
थैंक यू सर